We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Namaskar friends, today we will see one of the application associated with ultrasonic sound. Myself Dr. Marakna from VVP Engineering College, Rajkot. As you see from the first slide, animals like as a whale, bats, elephants, they use ultrasonic sound. They use ultrasonic sound for both the purpose, for navigation as well as for communication also, but it is not the case for human. As you know that our ear have a sensitivity of sound that is in range of 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, means 20k hertz, and that's why it is known as audible sound. Suppose frequency of sound that is less than 20 hertz, then it is known as infrasonic sound. But suppose that is higher than 20k, means 20,000 hertz, then it is known as ultrasonic sound. Ultrasonic sound have a n numbers of application that is associated with industry, for medical application. But here today our main focus that is on sonar. And you can imagine frequency range that is 20k, means 20,000 vibration per second. So it is very huge energy, and we are going to see how this energy we can utilize for sonar. And first thing is that sonar is stand for sound navigation and ranging. So name itself suggests here we have to use this ultrasonic sound for navigation purpose as well to find out the location of objects. It works on very simple principle that is known as echo sounding. From slide and picture you can easily understand what is echo. When sound wave hits a hard surface, obviously they might reflected and making the sound bounce and repeat. That is known as echo, means echo is nothing but repetition of sound. Whenever your reflecting surface that is far away, then sound reflected back in, suppose that is audible sound, same to same sound you are able to listen second time, third time, that is known as echo. In our local language that is known as padgo, echo. Basically this echo comes from the Greek word sound. As I already mentioned, many animals that use echo for navigation as well as for communication, but in now our due to ultra modern technologies, same to same principle we can adopt for our instruments, that is for our vehicles like as a submarines and warship. So whenever this ultrasonic waves transmitted through water, it is reflected by object in water and will produce an echo signal. Now question is that how to detect that, secondly how to produce that. And good thing is that now we have both the things. Suppose if you have seen my earlier lecture, then we have a major two technique for production of ultrasonic sound. One is known as magnetostriction method and second is piezoelectric transducer. So using this both the technique you can easily generate the ultrasonic sound. And then onwards we have a 5 technique by which you can easily detect the ultrasonic sound. Now we have both the things, means production also, we have technical point of view, we have a receiver also. So we have to first produce the ultrasonic sound that is reflected by surface and coming back. and that signal you have to receive. If we are able to do so, then we can easily satisfy our main purpose: sound, navigation and ranging. So here in this acoustically technique, high frequency ultrasonic we use, and main purpose of this topic is determine the depth of sea. Depth of sea you have to find out using ultrasonic sound. So from figure you can see that here you are able to see one ship. On point A you have one transducer, that is transmitting transducer, means here ultrasonic sound is produced. On other side you have a point B, on that you have a receiving transducer, means on point B you are able to receive the ultrasonic sound. The bottom of C, that is shown as point C. So here you have to use ultrasonic sound. It works on very simple principle, that is echo, and main purpose of this topic is find out the depth of sea. So whenever ultrasonic waves are transmitted through water, they reflected by object which are underwater. So this, due to that object, sound is reflected and receiver receive this sound, and then onwards we find out the depth of sea. Not only depth of sea, suppose if you use Doppler effect, on 12th you have a one topic, Doppler effect. One person that is standing over a platform and train is coming towards him, so sound intensity is increased, and suppose train is depart, then sound frequency slightly reduce with respect to time. So if we add this Doppler effect, then not only depth, velocity, distance and direction of object, that also we can easily measure. That we will see in our next topic. So once again, that is focus on our figure. So just remember, we have a two transducer, one is transmitting, second is receiving. So ultrasonic waves that is produced from point A, that is travel through the seawater and reflected back from the sea, and that reflected waves are received at point B. So we have a majorly two path, from A to C. So sound is produced from point A, that is travel through water and reflected from bottom of C, that is point C, and once again it reached to our receiving transducer B. So total distance traveled by wave, that is A to C and C to B. So using very simple equation, as you know that velocity is distance travel by time taken. So total distance traveled, that is A to C plus C to B, and time taken, that is T. This time you can easily measure using CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope. So it measures the time when sound is emitted and when sound is received. So here A to C, AC plus CB, that is very large distance. That's why you can easily say that AC is equal to OC is equal to OB. That's why total distance travel, that is 2CO divided by T. So CO, that is vertical distance between ship to bottom of sea. That's why it is known as the depth of sea, that is given by VT by 2. Very simple equation here. V, that is velocity of ultrasonic sound, that also you can easily measure. T, that is time, you have to measure using CRO divided by 2. So by this very simple formula, you are able to calculate the depth of sea. This instrument, means our sonar, that is also known as pathometer or echometer, when it is specially calibrated to determine the depth of sea. Sometime in absence of any obstacle, the ultrasonic waves do not get reflected to the receiving transducer. But in the presence of obstacle, ultrasonic waves get reflected and are picked up by receiving transducer. So if we know velocity and time, that is measured by CRO, we can easily measure the distance of sea. You all have seen the movie Titanic. In that, at that time they have a visual inspection, but suppose on that ship, if sonar is attached, at that time it is not available, but if suppose at that time it was there, then 110% you can easily escape from such a incident. So using sonar, distance and direction of submarine, depth of sea, depth of rocks in sea, school of fishes in sea, that you can easily determine. Not only that, we have n numbers of other application that is also associated with sonar. Among that, fish for fishing purpose, it is very useful. You can easily use sonar to find out the mass of fishes in a sea. Second use, that is military use. In military, you can easily detect, identify, and you can easily find out the location of submarine and other missiles by using our very similar and simple phenomena, that is echo sounding plus Doppler effect. For navigation also you can use sonar, because ultimately they gives the data about the any hidden object inside the water. Apart from navigation, you can easily do the reef monitoring. That is very useful for environmental and geological point of view. Here reef monitoring means you can easily study the coral and sand just above or below the surface of sea. I have put some figure also here, so by that way you can easily get the things. Not only that, sonar is used in various scientific applications such as water velocity management and wave measurement. So you can easily find out n numbers of other aspect also associate with our sonar. Thank you very much.